since hiring John Hines, his head coach, the Wild leads the league in goals against, average, and save percentage. The game is on. Pat Maroon. Goligoski drags it to the center. A rebound score by Johansson. Only his second goal of the year.
It looked like the Bruins maybe had an opportunity to make a play on the puck, but the retrieval by the power play unit, it was Johansson that got the retrieval. There's the nice little redirect in the bumper. Gets his own rebound, and before Omar can really get himself set back square because of the change of the direction of the shot, there's just too much net.
Lauko and Duer. No punches landed yet, and Lauko gets the hammer going.
Well, right after the drop of the puck, after the power play goal gave Minnesota a 1-0 lead, Jacob Lauko decided to try to get his team a little bit more emotionally involved in the hockey game. Not that it's a slow start or a sleepy start, but you give up the power play, and you give up the power play goal, trying to establish a bit more of an identity.
Johansson off Beecher's stick. Beecher blows by Bogosian, and Pasternak scores! John Beecher has offensive potential, and it starts with his defense and hustle.
And it's Beecher with a good stick here in the defensive zone. The pass back to the point, good stick, make the steal, and then his best strength is that straight-ahead speed. At his size, he can do more of this. Straight ahead speed, fight through your check, and then make a play when you come across the blue line. Well-timed.
Middleton to Boldy. To Rossi. And a good save by Omar, denying Kaprizov.
Yeah, that was a mistake by the Bruins in coverage at the defensive blue line. Had two checkers go to the puck area. That allowed for that two-on-one to happen coming across.
Hartman drops it. Frederick! A great save by Fleury. Deeks Kaprizov. 10 seconds to go. Pasternak to Zacha. Pasternak scores and beats the clock! Second to go.
Yeah, I wasn't even sure if it was to a full second yet. It might have been around two. But the effort all the way around. Nice to have Zacha back on the lineup. Makes a play along the wall. Attacks the net. Pasternak gets open on the weak side, but it starts right here. Pasternak comes deep. That's that short, effective 10-12-foot pass leads to the breakout. Transition play by Van Riemsdyk. Go hard around the boards, give your opponent, give your line mates an opportunity to make a play on a puck in the offensive zone as the clock's winding down.
Charlie Coyle wins the draw to open the second period. DeBrusque to Lindholm to Pasternak, loose in front. Jake DeBrusque tries to center and Joel Eriksson Ek clears.
Yeah, second unit moving the puck. I mean, they change out four guys. They keep Pasternak, but that unit moving the puck. Pasternak had a good opportunity.
Spinning moves, and Van Riemsdyk shot at the expiration. Zacha, Shattenkirk to Pasternak, and Zacha. A lunging save by Fleury. Middleton off a stanchion. Carlo backpedals. gives to McAvoy, to Pastrnak, a save by Fleury, a rebound save, and another. Shattenkirk in the weave, steps into the slot, and a kick save by Fleury. Pastrnak with Marchand coming late. Zacha, oh, it bounced over Pastrnak's blade.
But, you know, you're always wondering, how aggressive do you want to be early in the third period? You know, go extend the lead to make it 3-1. So the points of emphasis, obviously, are let's play aggressive.
Middleton, Faber, Boldy, catch and release, loose in the slot, a double save by Ullmark.
With a strong surge, and it's led by their top line. Spinorama wrist shot by Kaprizov, the rebound to Middleton, Ullmark. Unbelievable stop, not once but twice. The second one a beauty with the right.
At 22 minutes and 20 seconds of ice time before the drop. Faber to Middleton, hits the post, and Kaprizov cashes in. 6:48 to go, and it's 2-2.
Lindholm tries to get it out of the zone, going up the glass. Right there, it looked like Boston had a chance to make a play on the puck, but a good effort, good protection of the puck by Eriksson Ek. And then a shot through traffic that catches the post, and by doing so, it goes directly to Kaprizov, who has enough separation.
Marco Rossi spins off Geeky's check to Foligno. Saucer pass to Faber, who had an assist along with Middleton on the tying goal. Faber's shot, and Hartman scores.
Minnesota, five-man attack again, possessing the puck, using the width of the offensive zone, getting the defense involved. The Bruins get a shot blocked, but they can't corral the puck. And then that puck just finds Hartman.
McAvoy to Pastrnak, and Fleury can't find it. It's loose in front. Marchand scores! Fleury was playing with a skater stick, so it was 6-3.5.
Bruins possess the puck, the want, the will, the fight, keep plays alive. Minnesota couldn't push that puck under their goaltender and get a much-needed whistle. The Bruins just kept fighting away, find a way to find that puck. Marchand stayed out of the fray, was able to pull it out on the backhand to his forehand, threw it right up top to tie the hockey game.
Goligoski playing for the literal last shot. Carlo forks it out of there and will go to overtime. Zanek Kaprizov, who's played 23 minutes, 22 seconds, and Faber on the ice. Coyle. Boldy takes it away. The game is on Matt Boldy's stick, and it's in Linus Omark's trapper.
He thought he had an opportunity to take Boldy one-on-one, but Boldy wins that battle.
Charlie Coyle closes, and it's a 3-on-1. Eriksson Ek to Kaprizov, and the comeback is complete. Minnesota has a team builder at TD Garden, winning in overtime 4-3.
Grizzlick's in there. There's your shot by DeBrusk, with Coyle going to the net. I mean, DeBrusk is going to do the turnaway after the shot. Coyle's too far deep in the offensive zone to get back. There's too much ice, and you give up the numbers. And this is just a beautiful two-on-one. Erickson Ek to Kaprizov, catch and release. No chance for Omar. An impressive comeback win. Boston did a nice job to force overtime with the power play goal, but they lose it in extra time.